జనార్జిహంతు పితృత్వమన్యేష్య విచార్య పూర్ణం స్తంభేవతారస్తమన్యలభ్యం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం పదజ్ఞే శ్రీపాపనీయే ప్రతిమ ప్రభావం శ్రీకైత్తిరీయే కుచరోగిభీష్టః ఇతీవ పక్షీంద్రధరాధరస్త్వం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం పదజ్ఞే సంవర్గ విద్యా విలసత్స్వరూపం స్తంభైకడింబాత్మలసత్ప్రభావం త్రైలోక్య సంపూర్ణ నృసింహమూర్తిం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం పదజ్ఞే హిరణ్యదాతారమతీంద్రహేతో హిరణ్యహంతారమథాష్టబాహుం శాంతం సతాం ఉగ్రం అసత్సమాజే లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే సంతోషహాసేన సదారమాయాం వ్యాంతాననం స్వర్ణసటాభిరామం చిత్వాధరణ్యస్తమేక్షణాంతం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే సంచారయోగ్యాం చ పదావహంతం శ్రీపాదుకాం చేంచుసుతాం రమాం చ సజ్ఞేన హస్తేన పరిష్వజంతం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే శ్రీమద్వయార్థో హ్యహమేవ సత్యం ఇతీవ సర్వాన్ ప్రతిబోధయంతం సమానృసింహం త్వవిభక్తరూపం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే శ్రీవేంకటేశేన వివాహకాలే సంపూజితం సర్వవిధోపచారైః శ్రీశంఖచక్రాభయబాహుదీప్తం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే అహోబిలం సానుజ ఏత్య రామః త్వమాహరే యస్య చకార పూజాం పద్యైశ్చ పంచామృత భోగ్య శబ్దైః లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే సమాశ్రయార్థం త్వపరాధివర్గే సమాగతే తత్ర నివృత్త వక్త్రం శ్రీవాక్య సంతుష్ట కృపార్ద్ర నేత్రం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే సంచారయోగ్యం ప్రసమీక్ష్య కాలం కాలే కలౌ యస్త్వరయాభ్యషించత్ శ్రీవాసనామానమహో మునీంద్రం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే సమాశ్రితానామిహ సేవనార్థం అహోభిలేహ్యజ్ఞమఠే జ్వలంతం సువర్ణడోలా విలసత్స్వరూపం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే శ్రీవంశకారాతియతీంద్రపూర్వైః స్థానే విషిక్తైర్యతిరాజచంద్రైః సంపూజితం హ్యాత్మదమాత్మదానాం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే అహోబిలే గారుడశైలమధ్యే కృపావశాత్ కల్పిత సన్నిధానం లక్ష్మ్యా సమాలింగిత వామభాగం లక్ష్మీనృసింహం శరణం ప్రపద్యే లక్ష్మీనృసింహార్చన హృష్టచిత్తః భక్త్యైవ వేదాంత గురుర్యతీంద్రః లక్ష్మీనృసింహస్య శుభాం ప్రపత్తిం చక్రే జనానాం నిఖిలార్థసిద్ధ్యై శ్రీ నృసింహాష్టకం శ్రీమద్ పూర్ణ శశి కోటి శ్రీధర మనోహర సకాపటల కాంత పాలయ కృపాలయ భవాంబుది నిమగ్నం దైత్యవర కాల నరసింహ నరసింహ శ్రీమద కళంక పరిపూర్ణ శశి కోటి శ్రీధర మనోహర సకాపటల కాంత పాలయ కృపాలయ భవాంబుది నిమగ్నం దైత్యవర కాల నరసింహ నరసింహ పాతకమలావనక పాతకి జనానాం పాతక దవానల పతత్రివరకేతో పావన పరాయణ భవార్తి హరయామా పాహి కృపయైవ నరసింహ నరసింహ కుంగనఖ పంక్తి దళితాసురవరాశ్రక్ పంకనవ కుంకుమ విపంకిల మహోరహ పండిత నిధాన కమలాలయ నమస్తే పంకజ నిషణ్ణ నరసింహ నరసింహ మౌళిషు విభూషణమివామరవరాణాం యోగి హృదయేషు చ శిరస్సు నిగమానాం రాజదరవింద రుచిరం పదయుగం తే దేహి మమ మూర్ధి నరసింహ నరసింహ వారిజ విలోచన మదంతి మదశాయాం క్లేశ వివశీకృత సమస్త కరణాయ ఏహి రమయా సహ శరణ్య విహగానాం నాథమది రుహ్య నరసింహ నరసింహ హాటక కిరీట వరహార వనమాల తారరచనామ కరకుండల మణీంద్రై భూషితమశేష నిలయం తవ వపుర్మే చేతస చకాస్తు నరసింహ నరసింహ ఇందుర విపావక విలోచన రమాయా మందిర మహాభుజల సద్వర రథాంగ సుందర చిరాయ రమతాం త్వయి మనోమే నందిత సురేష నరసింహ నరసింహ మాధవ ముకుంద మధుసూదన మురారే వామన నృసింహ శరణం భవనతానాం కామద ఘృణిన్నిఖిల కారణ నయేయం కాలమరేష నరసింహ నరసింహ అష్టకమిదం సకల పాతక భయగ్నం కామదమశేష దురితామయ రిపుఘ్నం యః పఠతి సంతతమశేష నిలయం తే గచ్చతి పదం స నరసింహ నరసింహ
Submission and surrender unto them. The appearance of Lord Nrisimhadev is irrevocably or inseparably connected with Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad Nrisimha, Lakshmi Nrisimha in the spiritual world, and Prahlad Nrisimha as far as his appearance in this world. So naturally, attention goes to Prahlad. And in Srimad Bhagavatam, Prahlad reveals, of course there's different Prahlad Maharajas and different Puranas, but in Srimad Bhagavatam he reveals that he was Avaikunthavasi sent to this world to demonstrate in this world that the position of a pure devotee of the Lord. And as a pure devotee of the Lord, his first contact with transcendence was through Prahlad Maharaj, through Narada Muni. And that association with Narada Muni took place when Prahlad was still within the womb of his mother, Kayadu. Kayadu was the wife of Lord Nrisimhadev, the wife of Hiranyakashipu. And when Hiranyakashipu was off in the forest engaging in his austerity, the demigods understood that now the kingdom doesn't have him as their protector. They came, captured the kingdom of Hiranyakashipu as well as his wife, Kayadu. They saw that she was pregnant and they decided to hold her captive until the child was born and kill the child. Narada Muni came and stopped them and told them that within her womb is a great devotee. Please place her in my custody. So he brought her to this ashram situation where Narada Muni is instructing Kayadu in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Later, when Prahlad is explaining things to his classmates, they wanted to know, how'd you learn all these things about the Supreme Lord? He said, I heard from Narada Muni. And my mother, she heard also. But my mother, although she heard also, when she got back together with Hiranyakashipu, she forgot everything. But I didn't. So he's still remembering and explaining to his classmates everything that he heard. It's not in the Bhagavatam, but it's elsewhere, that Kayadu, being concerned that her child not be born in the absence of the father of the child, she asked Narada Muni for a benediction, that the child not be born until her father, the father of the child, returned. So Narada granted that benediction. It's for that reason that although Hiranyakashipu was off in the forest doing austerities for so long, Prahlad was still a little boy, or wasn't even born until he returned. And then as the little boy is growing, he's attending the school of the teacher. Brihaspati is the teacher of the demigods, and the sons of Shukracharya, Sanda and Amartha, they were the teachers of the school for the asuras. And Prahlad really didn't have any interest in those things. But when the teacher left the classroom, what happens when teachers leave the classroom? They play. Bedlam breaks out. So the children wanted to play, but Prahlad sat them down, and there's a whole chapter of Prahlad's instructions to his classmates. Some famous verses beginning with this one very famous, Komara Acharet Pragyo Dharman Bhagavataniha Durlabham Manusham Janma. Although the human form of life is Durlabham, and it's temporary, it's hard to achieve, and it's flickering and temporary, still it's very special, because it provides the opportunity for the fullness of God realization if it's taken up. So he describes that process and says, don't waste any time. You're children, as am I, so you're thinking, oh, we want to play. He goes through the whole lifespan of wasting time. So don't waste time. From the Komara Acharet Pragyo, from the tender age of childhood, Prabhupada's translation, one should engage in devotional service to Krishna. And so he invites them to join kirtan. So they're happy to be part of kirtan, except when the teachers come back and they see the children engaged in kirtan. And they panicked because they know that Hiranyakashipu's arch rival or enemy is Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu is his enemy because a form of Vishnu that preceded Lord Nrisimhadeva was Varaha, and Varaha killed his elder brother, Hiranyaksha. They were brothers, Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu, the descendants of Jayan Vijay from the spiritual world, to assist the Lord in his pastimes in this way. So they reported this, the teachers reported this to Hiranyakashipu. He was really upset. So he demanded Prahlad to describe, what's the best thing that you've learned in school? And he said, well, really, didn't learn anything good in school, but I can tell you the best thing that I've learned, and that's devotional service. Beginning with hearing and chanting, he describes the nine processes of bhakti. This is the best. So his father was so angry. Vishnu, devotional service to Vishnu, he's my enemy. So he told Sanda and Amarkas, you straighten out this boy, otherwise you're in big trouble. So they attempted, but it was too late. He already became disinfected by association with Narada Muni. And so Hiranyakashipu decided he wanted to have his son put to death. Not a nice man. So he tried in various ways, as these paintings illustrated. He had him surrounded by a pit of venomous snakes, being taunted by those ugly fellows there to torment Prahlad, but somehow the deadly serpents didn't strike. So he took him to in front of a wild elephant and had the wild elephant charge Prahlad, and nothing happened. So he had him taken to a cliff and had him pushed off a cliff. But Lord Vishnu was at the bottom to catch him. So he was saved. In the commentary on this particular verse, described Vishwanath Chakravarti, how he has these realizations, only Krishna knows. But he says what Lord Vishnu wanted to examine, the faith of Prahlad. So as Prahlad was falling, he wanted to see, is he going to scream? Is he going to panic? Is he going to cry? What's he going to do? But Prahlad was a perfect devotee. He was perfected through Vishnu Smaranam, through constant remembrance. So he was undeviated by the difficulty. Now, we may not have the difficulty of being put in a pit of snakes or trampled by a wild elephant or tossed off a cliff. We have our difficulties, not that severe. But Prahlad was unmoved. Just before he crashed to the rocks, Lord Vishnu appeared and caught him. Vishwanath explains. In a pot of boiling oil, he was untouched. And Hiranyakashipu was so frustrated. He brought his son, asked him, how is this possible? I'm the most powerful person in the universe. When I just raise my eyebrow, the demigods tremble in fear. And you, you're a little boy. You don't have any fear. And not only you don't have any fear, but I can't do anything to harm you. And I tried this and that and the other. And where are you getting your power? And the answer is, I'm getting my power from the same place you are, my dear demoniac father. And where is that place you're getting your power from? From Vishnu. No, Vishnu. Where is this Vishnu? I'll kill him. I'm so powerful and mighty, I'll kill him. Where is he? He's everywhere. Is he in this pillar? Yes, he's everywhere. So with his sword, he smashed the pillar. So now here's some images of Lord Nrisingadev coming out of the pillar. Now this particular image is taken from the Berkeley Temple. They have different images around the side, the wall paintings. Nice, very nice painting. And after he came bursting out of the pillar, he roared so loudly, the whole universe trembled. And what did Hiranyakashipu think? Oh, he has some mystic power, but I have some mystic power too, and my mystic power surpasses anyone's mystic power. So he started battling Lord Nrisimhadev. And the description in the Bhagavatam is really interesting, like so many of the fighting descriptions in the Bhagavatam. This way, that way. The demigods were, you know, slay him, finish him. He's a terrible demon. And so, after playing, Prabhupada gives the example like a cat plays with a mouse. I don't know if you've seen, I've seen. The cat just watches the mouse and the mouse is trembling and the mouse starts to run, the cat catches the mouse, drops the mouse down again. The mouse is trembling. So he liked that. He was playing with Hiranyakashipu and then finally finished him. And there's the most paintings of all of Hiranyakashipu finishing him. Because the terrible demon Hiranyakashipu felt he was invincible. When he went off to the forest to engage in his austerities, he was seeking from Lord Brahma immortality. His reasoning was, right now, I'm the leading person and the ruler of the universe. But all bodies have to die, so all I need to do is become immortal, and then I'll be God. I'll be rule the universe forever. 2 plus 2. But to get immortality, he wanted to get immortality from Lord Brahma. So he underwent these difficult austerities. And when Brahma came and said, what is the benediction that you would like? He wanted immortality. And Brahma said, I can't give you immortality because I don't have it. I can only give you what I have, so ask something that I can give you. So in a very calculating way, he said, well, then let me not be killed inside or outside. Okay. Let me not be killed in the air or the land or the sea. Okay. Let me not be killed by any weapon. Okay. What else? And he went down his whole list of how he couldn't be killed. But he didn't ask to not be killed by a half man or half lion. Neither man nor beast, neither inside or out. So on the veranda, or between the inside and the outside, at sunset, so it was neither day nor night, on the lap of Lord Nrisimhadev, because it was neither in the air nor in the land or in the sea, and with the Lord's nails. It wasn't by any weapon. Checkmate. And Prabhupada would like to comment, the materialist is always trying to maneuver or counteract the miseries of material existence, but the Lord is more clever. There's always going to be something. And so Lord Nrisimhadev appeared and placed Hiranyakashipu across his lap and with his nails bifurcated his body, roaring very loudly, and removed the insides and brought them outside, and then took the garland of some of his intestines, or took some of his intestines and placed it around his neck as a garland. Pretty bloody. Here's a number of paintings of the same pastime. Here's Nrisimha blue. I forget what the Sanskrit is, but it's a particular feature of Lord Nrisimhadev. Some very old styled paintings. That very nice ISKCON painting. Lord Nrisimhadev dressed very nicely, and look at Hiranyakashipu, looks like he's in pajamas or something. Of course, Prahlad and Lakshmi. Prahlad by his feet. this in the painting. He looks like a bunny rabbit. And after Hiranyakashipu was finished, the soldiers and the assistants of Hiranyakashipu came out by the thousands. And so Lord Nrisimhadev to retaliate. And Lord Nrisimhadev manifested many, 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 many arms and simply grabbed these associates of Hiranyakashipu and threw them in the air and smashed them into pieces, and the whole entourage of Hiranyakashipu was finished at once. The demigods had come to see the finishing of Hiranyakashipu, and when the Lord was finishing Hiranyakashipu, they came before him and offered prayers. There's a whole chapter in the seventh canto, the prayers of the demigods to Lord Nrisimhadev, similar to the canto 10 when Krishna appeared, a little different style appearance. And after they were unable to pacify Lord Nrisimhadev, who was still roaring very, very loudly, they understood the only way to pacify Lord Nrisimhadev was to have Prahlad come forward, because the Lord appeared for him to protect him. Perhaps he can pacify. So, under the order of the demigods, Prahlad approached Lord Nrisimhadev and offered beautiful prayers. There's a whole section of the Bhagavatam that's very, very wonderful. And after hearing the prayers of Prahlad, Lord Nrisimhadev became very pacified. And Lord Nrisimhadev placed him on his lap. And Prahlad offered him a nice garland. And Lord Nrisimhadev honored Prahlad by placing his hand upon Prahlad's head. Prahlad appreciated, this is a benediction even the goddess of fortune hasn't received. You're being so kind to me. And then come many standard paintings of, there's Hiranyakashipu at the bottom, and Prahlad and Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, and other associates of the Supreme Personality of Godhead assembled around him, honoring him and praising him. We're used to, in ISKCON, seeing the Das Avatar features, not with Lord Nrisimhadev at the center, but he's such a popular form of the Lord. Here's a poster with Lord Nrisimhadev in the middle, of course Vishnu at the bottom, and the forms of the Leela avatars on either side. Now we're going to start visiting places where there's Nrisimha deities, seeing images of those deities, and we're going to start with Ahovalam. There was a Back to Godhead article featuring one of Prabhupada's disciples, Dharmatma, had a son who from his early childhood had fascination for Lord Nrisimhadev. So as a little boy, he had little opportunity for earning some money, and he saved all his money so he could one day go to India and visit Nrisimha temples. So one of those Nrisimha temples that he visited was Ahovalam, according to this BTG article. And the first place that he went was Puri, where he had a deity of Lord Nrisimhadev carved. And then he went to Ahovalam and made friendship with one of the guides that made an arrangement for him to see all of the temples. Has anybody here been to Ahovalam? It's really remote, like jungly, as they say. And so it's not at all commercial, and it's just the opposite. It's there's wild animals all over the place, and treacherous to get around. But this nice guide made a special arrangement for Dhruva that he would take him to the main temples, which normally can take several days, he did it all in one day. So we're going to visit. We'll see the last place they went. Here's a very famous place where you see, here's a set of stone steps leading up to a cave. It is said this is where Prahlad Maharaj did his meditation. Some say also in this area down here is where he gave his classes to the boys. And up here, way on top of this peak, is where Lord Ishingadev appeared. And to get there, it's dangerous. I mean, you can't go from the front side, you have to go from the back side, but even from the back side, it's pretty steep. Did you go all the way? No. Halfway? No. And at the very, very top is this stumbha that at least the local people say that's where the pillar was from which Lord Nrisimhadev appeared. Now, a little ISKCON history is some devotees very, very early in the movement were sent by Srila Prabhupada to visit temples in South India and see how they do their deity worship. And so from that learning, because they're interested in deity worship, to see what features of that deity worship could be applied in ISKCON. It was Achyutananda and Yasoda Nandana. So they asked Prabhupada where they went. We visited Ahovalam, and they say that this is the place where Lord Nrisimhadev appeared. But it says in the Bhagavatam that Lord Nrisimhadev, that Hiranyakashipu had taken over the kingdom of Indra, and so where he resided is Indra's kingdom in Indraloka, and that's where Lord Nrisimhadev appeared. So which is it, Prabhupada? And he didn't give a yes or no answer. He said, because of the intensity of the devotion in Ahovalam for the centuries and centuries and centuries, Lord Nrisimhadev is there. And whether it was here or there, Lord Nrisimhadev is there. It was something like that was his answer. That when you visit such places as this, the Nrisimha Bhakti is very strong. And at this very uppermost place of the Nrisimha temple, there's this little space, and when the guide in Dhruva, he narrates this, when they got to the top, it was the sun had set, so it was dark, and to go back down when it's dark, you can't do that. So he said, let us spend the night in this little space, and he closed the door from the inside. And as they were taking rest, Dhruva says he heard some noise outside, and he asked, what's that? He said, don't worry about it, just take rest. And then in the morning, the guide told him it was a bear. And he smelled us, and that's why we were inside, so we could live to tell the next day. It's wilderness in the Ahovalam. This is one of the temples where, in this case, Krodha Nrisimha, a certain deity is worshipped in the form of Krodha Nrisimha and Varaha Nrisimha, you know, really, really old. And one can only imagine how many centuries and centuries and centuries and lifetimes of worshippers have been here and gone. But here's this Varaha Nrisimha deity and Krodha Nrisimha next to him. Here's a close-up. If you look carefully, you can see the nose of Varaha lifting earth. Here's a close-up. Varaha Nrisimha. And this isn't one of the principal, 10 principal deities. But the first of the principal deities is this one, Ahobilam Nrisimha. And here's a image of Ahobilam in the middle. Bhargava Nrisimha, one of the principal deities, and Pavana Nrisimha we're going to see again. So this Ahobilam deity is at the bottom of the hill, along with this, a major temple, the Lakshmi Nrisimha temple, a very majestic temple. We're going to see the outside of the temple shortly. So of the, excuse me, it's nine. The first is this Lakshmi Nrisimha, then Bhargava Nrisimha is number two. Bhargava Nrisimha is named after Lord Parashuram because it is said that Parashuram, one of the places he engaged in austerities, was nearby. And so they named this deity after him, Bhargava Nrisimha. And then Chatur Vada Nrisimha, there's a few images of him. He has a big smile. And this deity amongst them, because they're all very, very old, is the best preserved of all of them. Nice smile. Offering benedictions. And the, so the slaying of Hiranyakashipu isn't part of the mood, it's different. And this nice pose with one of his hands on his hip. Nicely decorated. Then Yogananda Nrisimha. Now, those that have engaged in deity worship know different deities have different moods, and those moods are experienced by the ardent worshippers, so they understand the mood of the deity. This Yogananda Nrisimha is said by the locals to be most merciful of all the forms of Lord Nrisimhadev worshipped in Nahovalam. And it's something like, for us, it's something like Lord Nityananda being the most merciful of the most merciful Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Here's the text at the bottom. This is the artist illustration of the mood. And maybe some of you have seen these straps that go around the knees that sometimes at yoga classes they have them. It assists the yoga practitioner of sitting there in the same posture and not being so uncomfortable. You know, it's not Lord Nrisimhadev picked it up from the yoga teachers, but the other way around. And Karanja Nrisimha. Karanja Nrisimha is the number five in these principal deities of Ahovalam. And he has his name derived from a particular tree called the Karanja tree that seems to be particularly prominent in the Ahovalam area. So he's got his bow and his chakra. There's Sudarshan at the top. Now, Ugra Nrisimha is, now we're getting into the mood of killing Hiranyakashipu. This Ugra Nrisimha form is a few things. It's not to be worshipped by householders, Lakshmi Nrisimha or Prahlad Nrisimha, but not Ugra Nrisimha, because of the mood. The mood is very intense, destroy Hiranyakashipu mood. So there must be some further explanation, but that's the explanation that I've heard again and again. Just like in Mayapur, we'll see images of the Mayapur Nrisimha deity. And just on the topic of the mood of the deity, there was a time, of course, when in Mayapur there wasn't a Nrisimha deity, but two things happened. One thing that happened was some dacoits thought the deity of Radha Madhava, brass deities, because Radha was particularly golden in color, they thought she was made of gold. So in the middle of the night they came and broke into the temple room and stole Radha Krishna, or Radha Madhava. And on their way out, running out of the campus, the devotees found out that they had broken in, and they came out with shotguns. And maybe some of you know Bhakti Raghava Swami, who has half of his leg missing because he got shot trying to rescue the deity from the dacoits. So he had half of his leg amputated from the damage of the leg. And then so they got security, and something else happened, and so they decided to give protection to the Dham by having a Nrisimha deity. And Janani Vas describes this on the way. He and the others that were going, one other, had a dream. They both had the same dream of the form of Ugra Nrisimha. And they conferred when they woke up. And so that when they were going to South India to a very, very famous murti maker. And they wanted the best for Mayapur. And so when they got there, it is ascribed to the murti maker the form that they saw in their dream. So he knew exactly what the form was, because that's his specialty. And there was somewhere, so the man got his deposit and started making the deity. Takes some long time to make deities properly. And some envious man found out about the ISKCON devotees making the deity. So he went to the murti maker and said, "Don't make it for them, I'll pay you double what they paid, just give me the deity." He said, "No, I can't. I receive money from them." He said, "But you know, you don't want them to have this deity because you don't want them to have that protection, but you should know this particular deity, if you make a mistake in worshiping this particular deity, you'll be destroyed." He said, "Oh, hurry up and finish the deity." Because he was a very envious man. And then the devotees came to see the deity when the deity was completed. And when the deity was completed, it was awesome. And the deity maker told them the story. This man had come, he offered me double the money. And I said no. And I told him that if you make offense, then you'll be destroyed. So he was very happy. But what I didn't tell him was that when Nrisimha Dev, he must be worshipped on a separate altar, but when he's worshipped in conjunction with some other deity, he takes on the mood of the other deity. So the worship of a particular deity is important, and the mood of a particular deity is important. You know, especially, or at least, for those who become deeply involved in deity worship. They have an understanding of the nature of the deity and the mood of the deity. Here's where this Ugra Nrisimha Mandir is, way up at another, on top of some hill or hillock. And Jwala Nrisimha is at this spot at the top of the hill we saw before in the altar. And of course Lakshmi Nrisimha is by his side. Then another, I've seen it in both ways, so I put both Moha Lola or Malola, where Ma means mother or goddess Lakshmi, and Lola means beloved. So the Malola Nrisimha is where Lakshmi, when she saw this form of the Lord, she was I've never seen this form before of yours. And so she underwent austerities to pacify her beloved Lord. And Bhavan Nrisimha is the final form of the Lord, of these principal deities. Nice offerings, nice standard of worship, certainly decades and decades and centuries of worship of these deities. There's a self-manifesting deity, just like in Vrindavan, the Radharaman deity is manifest from Shalagram Shila because of the intensity of the devotion of Gopal Bhatta, and similarly the intensity of devotion of Nrisimha Bhaktas. Nrisimha made his personal appearance from a Shila in one of the caves in the Hovalam. And here he's been worshipped for who knows how long. Another famous deity is this Pavana Nrisimha in Ahovalam. And particularly this deity is given the name, but it has the mood of peacefulness. So if you want to be peaceful, you can worship Pavana Nrisimha. I'd like to be peaceful one of these days. That'd be nice. So this is some carvings on the outside of the temple that's at the bottom of the hill. Of course, we know who this is. Here's this Yogananda Nrisimha again, and other features, Lord Varaha, up here. And this is an image of the deity of Nrisimhadev in the Bavarian forest in Germany. Deep, deep inside a deep forest temple is Lord Nrisimhadev and Prahlad Maharaj. The deity is so huge that they had to rent a crane to lift the deity out of the back of the truck and place the deity on the altar, and then built the rest of the temple around the altar. Because he was so big, that deity's not going anywhere. And he's very nicely worshipped, as you can see, in traditional South Indian style. Here's the golden coins around his ankle, and very, very, very opulent worship. Golden necklace, the symbols of Vishnu. There's several images. Here's the whole altar. They have no, this photograph is taken with lights, but otherwise it's just lamps in traditional South Indian style. You'll see these again later, I'll make mention, yantras you'll see on the altar in Mayapur also. But they have a special role or function in South Indian deity worship. Here's that same deity, Prahlad Nrisimha, in different dresses. Very nicely worshipped. Close up. And of course our deity in Mayapur. And then the deity in Mayapur is in this Ugra Nrisimha pose because his arms are raised, ready to pounce on Hiranyakashipu. But on Chandan Yatra, you can see he has a big smile. He's showing his teeth and showing his nails, but that's for Hiranyakashipu, for the devotees, is this big smile. In one of the islands in Navadvip, when you go to visit Shidam Mayapur, you go in Prikrama, and one of the places that you go to is Nrisimha Pali. As you can see, this deity is really ancient, and you have to look really closely, but this is the arms of Lord Nrisimhadev, and vertically across his lap is Hiranyakashipu. There's his legs. And it's a wonderful place for kirtan. Every time I've been there, something happens, and kirtan is just really, really special. Here's a close-up of the deity, Hiranyakashipu and Lord Nrisimhadev. And so after the local history, according to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, is when Lord Nrisimhadev killed Hiranyakashipu, came here, washed his hands in this lake. Exactly, previously was a river, and he became pacified. This is where the locals come and offer their respects to the sacred water. Anyone recognize this deity? Simachalam. Simachalam is in Andhra Pradesh near Vishakhapatnam, and it's way up on a hill. It's the same up on a hill place as this painting, where after Nrisimhadev destroyed Hiranyakashipu, he came to this place and he was still in this angry mood. So according to the description, history of the place, King Pururava and Urvashi happened to be passing by, and the Lord indicated them that he wanted them to engage in his worship. And so they engaged in his worship. And one of the things that he also then requested was, because of his anger, that he should be covered with chandan to cool him. And so there's this procedure in Simachalam. Those of you that are from the area, you know. In certain intervals of time, more and 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 more chandan is applied to the deity, to the point where it just looks like a big lump of chandan. And you can't see the deity inside. But Akshaya Tritiya, once a year, is a big festival, and they take away all the chandan. Big festival. And then for one day, imagine what the lines are like, for one day you can have darshan of the deity not covered by chandan. And it goes on all day, and special ceremonies and special brahmanas reciting special prayers. The whole grand I've spoken with devotees who participated in the festival. You have to have some Brahmins who are your friends, then you can do it. So they participate all night long, and then until the next morning, and the next morning is the ritual of offering the first layers of chandan and so on. So this is the Simachalam temple from the outside. And of course there's a number of other very famous, well-known deities of Lord Nrisimhadev in particularly South India. Mangalagiri near Vijayawada. I visited when we did our South India tour. That's one of the places we visited. And I heard about it before I went there, so it was like anticipating, looking forward to. What happens is, for a few rupees, you can purchase some jaggery, and that you go before the deity. The pujari takes the jaggery, and he pours the jaggery in the mouth of the deity, and you can hear, oh, 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 oh. And then you hear this belch. That means there's, you know, don't pour anymore. And then they give you back the remaining clay pot that has jaggery in it that's been offered to Lord Nrisimhadev. So I asked the devotee, you know, do they have like, you know, a big pot underneath the deity or something that's catching the jaggery? And he said, people have checked that out. He said, it's just the deity drinks the jaggery. It's just what this deity does. So he's a very happy deity. He likes jaggery. And when you visit, you can see, you can offer, and he'll accept. It's not well lit like this when you go, but you know, some few rupees were paid, obviously, and there's the deity, Mangalagiri. And north of Hyderabad, another place that I visited, Nrisimha Yada Girigutta, and Lord Nrisimhadev and Lakshmi. This is the image that they sell at the shops. Famous deity, very merciful deity, very popular deity. And in Chennai, that image that you saw at the very beginning, this is another Sholingur, deity of Lord Nrisimhadev. He's in this yoga pose also, with Shibu and Nila at the bottom. Another famous at least amongst the Sri Vaishnavas, the famous deity is in part famous because of the Pujari. I don't believe he's alive anymore, but since he was a little boy, he would spend hours every day chanting the mantras and worshipping the deity in a grand style. And as he got older and older and older, it became a little difficult because the deity is tall, so he'd have to have a special place to stand to bathe the deity and worship the deity. And he's one of their celebrities or famous sadhus in the area. Other forms of Nrisingadev, some are found in Vrindavan. There's a form of Nrisingadev, one that Nanda Maharaj worshipped. Over on this side is Nanda and over here is Krishna. Near Nandagram, place where Nanda Maharaj engaged in some worship of Lord Nrisingadev. There's a cave situation where there's a deity of Lord Nrisingadev. There's one, if you go circumambulate Govardhan Hill and towards almost at the very southern end of Govardhan Hill, there's a kind of a temple up on a hill, and it's a nice place to go for rest if you need rest or just to see Lord Nrisingadev. And I've been there a few times, and you have to ask the pujari. He doesn't do this unless you ask him. And then he pulls back the dress of the deity, and he shows beneath the dress of the deity there's the body of Hiranyakashipu, who is stretched over the knees of Lord Nrisingadev. And he puts the dress down. Anybody recognize this deity? Udupi. This is the Krishna, the main deity in Udupi is the Krishna deity. And the Krishna deity on different occasions is dressed according to the occasion. So on Nrisingha Chaturdasi, he's dressed this way. The mood and got his battle outfit on to battle Hiranyakashipu. And of the other temples, they have forms of the Lord, the avatar forms of the Lord, and there's the Udupi Nrisingha deity. In Jaipur, in the same temple as Madan Mohan, on this altar in the center, that Madan Mohan are in front of you, and over to the left is another altar for Lord Nrisingadev. There's another dress of Lord Nrisingadev and the deities there. This deity is where? New Vrindavan. Special altar of Lord Nrisingadev, Prahlad Nrisingha. This is in ISKCON Bangalore temple, the walking up the steps before you enter the main temple. Who knows where this is? Silicon Valley. Little history. Vaisheshika Prabhu has many wonderful qualities. One of them is he likes reciting mantras and he likes reciting Nrisingha mantras. And so somebody in Mexico said, I know you're a Nrisingha Bhakta. We have, our family has this deity. We're not able to maintain the worship properly. Would you accept? So he accepted, and now the deity is there on their altar. Very attractive deity with beautiful lotus feet. And their little Nrisingadev in the front. This is a deity of Nrisingadev that, well, if you believe the story, remember when there was this tornado or cyclone or something that hit Puri, the east coast of Orissa, and according to one story, a branch of the Siddha Bakul broke during that storm, So Indradyumna Maharaj and Ramabhadra used to go together to Puri regularly. They made a friendship with this particular murti maker, and he claims these are now in Ramabhadra's office, but it's silk, gold-leafed Lord Nrisimhadev, made from Siddha Bakul in Puri. And some standard South Indian deity forms of Lord Nrisimhadev, families in their home are worshipping. They look similar, but they're different murtis. Driti, one of the famous, really famous, fabulous ISKCON artists from the BBT days, and still is painting. She and her husband worship Lord Nrisimhadev at Three Rivers. That's their family deity. And then there's Nrisimhashilas with specific markings. This is Sridhar Swami, my godbrother and dear friend, and his Nrisimhashilas, he had a number of them. When he was diagnosed as having hepatitis C and the doctor said, you only have a short amount of time, he immediately began Lord Nrisimhadev worship. This is his Nrisimha deity. And the previous one is the Shalagram Shila that he worshipped. And he really, really got into it. I mean, whatever he did, he really got into it. So he really got into Nrisimha worship. And somehow his life span expanded. And so he then took some interest. For many, many years he was in Juhu, the principal fundraiser for the Juhu temple and preacher. So he then took an interest in helping the TOVP, way back before they started construction. So he went with his disciple to Epcot Center to see, maybe he could learn something about how they do things in Epcot and he could use it in Mayapur for the TOVP. So he went and visited and came back, and when he came back, his car had been vandalized. Including what had been vandalized was his Nrisimha deity and all his paraphernalia. And then he came back to New York, and I said, whew, whoever did this, stealing the property of a Brahmin and a sannyasi and Lord Nrisimhadev, they're going to catch it. And Maharaj said, no. He said, Lord Nrisimhadev is very merciful. He said, well, he may be very merciful, but they are thieves. And said, no. Somehow, he just had this deep conviction, somehow the mercy of Lord Nrisimhadev is going to come to them. I just shrugged my shoulders. There's a number of others, forms of Shalagram forms, see the sword, and there's some markings in the inside of their mouth with lines. Here's a bow. On the outside of temples, carvings of Nrisimhadev. Here again, in Leela form, here's Lord Nrisimhadev coming out of the pillar, breaking out of the pillar, starting his battle with Hiranyakashipu, putting Hiranyakashipu over his lap and finishing him. And just taking a look at this image, how many centuries of worship have been performed by how many lives of how many devotees? And as you look at these deities, just imagine how much worship has gone on. This is an image from Sotheby's. I mean, some of you may know, it's a place where they auction art. So one devotee I know took an interest in this particular art piece, 11th century art piece, and he made a bid. But it was way too low. The one that won the bid was $64,800. And there was, 10 arms that are broken off or something like that. But all of these forms that you see, that they're not going to be auctioned at Sotheby's, but they're very, very old, and very special and very valuable. Another form of Lord Nrisimhadev with his Ugra Nrisimha mood. Different one. Now we're back in Mayapur. This is the Abhishek. And there he is, very happy. Lord Nrisimhadev. Here's with ghee and with milk. Of course, we don't have a Nrisimha deity here, so we don't have the Abhishek, but we're seeing that Abhishek in Mayapur. And after bathing with all these substances, then comes the flowers. Pretty spectacular. Line drawings of the forms of Lord Nrisimhadev. I once showed this at Potomac, and right in the middle of showing these, Cora, what's Rukmini's son's name? Gauravani. Gauravani said, "Wow, that would make a great t-shirt. Can I get a copy of that?" Images of Lord Nrisimha. So this is the, I mentioned these brass plates that are called yantras. You'll find that term in Brahma Samhita. Yantra is a two-dimensional depiction of the spiritual world inscribed in with certain Sanskrit terms, but it's what it means is, overall, it's the abode of Lord Nrisimhadev, and he's at the center, and he's being worshipped by various mantras. And worship of yantras goes along with the worship of the deity. There's the two of them. One and two. Over here is Prahlad. At the feet of Lord Nrisimhadev in Mayapur, there's many, many, many Shalagram Shilas. Of course, the principal one in the front. Nice deity dress. And by his side is Prahlad. Of course, you can't see so close up like this when you're seeing from a distance, but with photographs you can see his very pleasant features. And again, Lord Nrisimhadev appears because of protecting Prahlad. So shown in the image is this sharp teeth mentioned. Prahlad says, "I'm not afraid of these pinching teeth and sharp claws, because I know they're meant for demons. But for the devotees, he just is the offer of protection and mercy. But when you mess with Prahlad, look out." Now, we'll leave Mayapur and just take a quick look, and we'll finish up. There's many, many, many places where Lord Nrisimhadev deities are kept. Dhruva collected these paintings or these photographs. I asked him to give me the names and the story behind the deities, and he said, "I'm going to come out with a book, so I'm not going to tell you." But he gave me the images. Worship by Tulsi. Again, think of the centuries of worship that these forms have received. There's the Utsav Murti at the bottom. And the Murti, the principal Murti, receiving the worship here. Standards nicely kept. Sometimes very simple like this. Very elaborate worship here. I don't know the reason they seem to like to give him a mustache. He's got a big handlebar mustache. But he's the recipient of so much love and devotion, and he gives his protection to his devotee. Even on the side of walls. You know, in America it's graffiti, but in South India it's Lord Nrisimhadev. So this is the close. This is our deity in Mayapur, Lord Nrisimhadev, in different outfits, dressed very wonderfully, worshipped very wonderfully, decorated very wonderfully, offering his benedictions to many, many devotees. There's wonderful stories. There's a whole book of the reciprocation of this deity in Mayapur with different devotees, not just one devotee or a few devotees, but some amazing, a little booklet describing, I'll just say one of those stories. Devotee, a brahmachari, who was worshipping Lord Nrisimhadev, was a little concerned. You see the big, bright red eyes. Maybe people that come to see Lord Nrisimhadev, they'd be put off by bright red eyes, so he decided to change the eyes of the deity to some other color, green or something. And one morning when he was beginning the worship, he closed the door. It's the kind of altar, there's only one entrance. You don't have like two entrances. He closed the door, and he heard this deep, solemn voice saying, "Replace my eyes." And he looked around, who said that? There wasn't anybody but Lord Nrisimhadev. And then it happened again the next morning. So he became fearful. So he asked Jananivas, what was that? And he said, and he asked him, you changed the eyes of the deity from the red one to the green ones. The deity's telling you he wants his eyes back. Put the other ones back. So he did, and that's what this there to till day. Reciprocation sometimes can just be letting you know that the deity is a person, not necessarily fulfilling some wish on your wish list, but engaging in loving exchange between the deity and the worshipper. And this deity has been worshipped even in the rainy season. Sometimes the floods in Mayapur become so severe that the deity up to his shoulders gets immersed in water, but never has it gone above. So this is the pujari who's offering a flower. The pujari is submerged, but the deity is not. So all of this wonderful lore, at least, many of you, of course, from India, you've heard many of these deities and many of the stories of Lord Nrisimhadev and his exchange with Prahlad and so forth, but for the rest of the world, where it's all happening because of the mercy of our founder Acharya, to be gathered together in a temple like this, hearing the glories of Lord Nrisimhadev in some remote part of the world, particularly from where Nrisimhadev is customarily worshipped, it's Prabhupada's mercy. So we're honoring Prabhupada along with Lord Nrisimhadev on his appearance day. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Nrisimha Bhagavan ki jai. And the sun has set, so you can take prasadam. Okay, go right ahead.
Also,